Howdy everyone, it's Hillbilly-creations. Today we are back in the garage working on the 1967 Jacobsen Chief. Today we are going to hopefully get the back part done, get all that fabricating done, the painting done. Today we are going to be buffing it, sanding it, priming it, letting that cure, and then we will be painting it. So let's get right into the video here. So since the last time I posted a video, I replaced the bottom, did my welds, grinded it up, put some rock guard on it. I have that video too. I just gotta do some editing on it to clean it up a little bit. But let's get right into this video here, and I'm just gonna flip this around. So I'm gonna be buffing all this, sanding it all down smoothly, getting it all ready for primer, and then we're gonna prime and paint. Don't mind the noise, we need a little actually cleaning up fairly nice from sitting for how long under a big old maple tree. You know, it's actually cleaned up very nice and smooth, getting all the little pits out of it. Just the way I like it, nice and smooth. I'm going to go to the next one. She's a wee bit rusty in there.
I think I nailed a little bit of that stuff.
But anyways, it is actually cleaning up very nice. Show you guys here.
So it is kind of very smooth.
Probably not very nice for what I need it for, because, you know, it's an off-road build. Cleaned up, and now I'm just going to give her a little coat of primer, maybe one or two coats of primer to thicken it up. Just shake it up real good. I know it should be painted outside, but you know, British Columbia's weather. It looks like it's going to rain, so. If you don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes. Should clear up. Thank you. We got that all primer when I want to prime. The inside right there I'm not going to worry about because I am actually putting the battery box in there, so I'm not too worried about that. And we'll let the primer dry and then I'll be back with you guys. Okay. Primer's dry, cured. Should be good to do a coat of paint now. Like I said in my previous videos, we're using Kubota orange. It's the closest I can find to the Jacobsen orange. Must have clumps in there. We're here for that part, and I shall let that first coat dry. I'm probably going to do probably two or three coats of the Kubota orange here. So I'll let that dry, and then I'll be back with you guys. Okay, the paint is just about dry, so while the paint's finishing up drying, I figured I was going to weld on my foot tag here. I got it all set. I got it all cleaned up where the ground is going for welding. And I'm just going to weld it on, back on there, see where it sits. Okay, I'm engine attack got on there. I couldn't sit there and not do anything while the paint dried, so I figured I'd do this and get it out of the way. So, let's get welded. Hey, I got it brought out a little bit, so I'm going to fill this little hole in right here with weld, and I'm just going to do a little bead weld in the back there, and that should be pretty good for what I need it for. So, let's get to it. Got that? Put a little cap on the left side here. Thank you. lighten up. And hopefully by the time I'm done this, the paint will be dry and then I can put the back part back on and see where it sets. Pretty good like that. Hold my weight. Hey! Paint is dry. I got the back on now. Next, I need to let it finish. Dry, and then just start fabricating up the exhaust and getting this thing on the trails. Okay, maybe I'll put the seat on there and see what it all looks like. Not too bad. Foot pegs in the right position, matches up with the other side. Now pretty soon we'll be able to get this tractor on the trails, and you know, you guys stick with my channel and I'll be coming up with some adventures with it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and I'll see you guys on the next one.